whatever it is, you can fix it and start a conversation, stimulate a conversation. So I just wanted to share that with you. Well, let's do open forum now. Anybody here ever make a mistake in business? Okay, I made a mistake. I made a mistake last week. I make mistakes too, all the time. I had somebody on the phone, sweet talked me, asked me for information, made a commitment, sent a contract back and everything. And then the person promised to pay me on Monday. Monday turned into Tuesday, then Wednesday. Then we're all the way to Friday. Still haven't received the monies promised, even though I did everything I said. What do you think I did on Friday with this person when I got him on the phone?
You fired him.
I fired him. Why?
Because you want them to know they didn't hold up their end of the bargain. You don't need them. You're moving on.
How do you deal with a... Here's the word, your word of the day or words, pathological liar. Have we met this person? Have you, has everybody met the consistent pathological liar?
I'm on TV every day.
Okay, they just lie. And in business, they just lie. Oh, Claude, no problem. The check, the wire transfer, the contract, this will be back by Tuesday. No problem whatsoever. Tuesday comes, nothing. Wednesday, you text. They say, oh, I'll take care of it. Sorry, got a little busy. And then it turns into fraud, constant lying. Some people are very, very good at manipulation, and I should have known better. Guess what? I was so mad at my, you ever get mad at yourself, anybody here?
Yep.
Oh, got so mad at my, I said, I teach this stuff all day long, and here I am being Mr., being dumb, you know?
What's amazing about people like that is they'll lie even when it's in their best interest to tell the truth.
Claude, what did you say to fire him?
I said, I'll tell you verbatim. I said, I'll use a different name. I said, Mr. Smith, does it say schmuck on my forehead? We were on Zoom. I said, why? Is this the way you always do business, sir? Little pregnant pause. Oh, well, no, Claude, I'm sorry. And this and that. I said, but we spoke several times. We texted, we communicated. And every time you made a promise, I said, do you go through life just lying? Because we shouldn't be doing business together, because there's no way. There's just no future in it. And I said, I've made a decision and I've only made it a few times in my life. You're fired. Little Donald Trump from that TV show thing there. I really said that. That was almost verbatim what I just said here right now. My ego's so frail, I wanted to get the last word, total honesty.
And if he calls back to try to send you the check or contract or whatever, what would you say to him at that time?
Sir, did I stutter? Sir, why are you calling me? It's over. You made the greatest, and then I'm just going to throw a little more salt on the wound. I'm going to say, don't you realize you made the greatest financial mistake of your life? It's over, sir. Goodbye. Boom. Is that petty to get the last? Is that really petty to get the last word in? Is that immature? I don't care.
Was this on a deal or was this?
That was fine.
Was it a mentoring or was this for a deal?
I don't want to go into specifics.
Oh, I just want to know if you.
If they
lost the goose with the golden. The golden egg.
It was a very healthy deal. It was a win-win. The money issue. I think it was a money issue. It's always a money
it's
issue.
Money issue.
Isn't it always a money issue? And I was a nice guy, Claude, and I should have said, if it's not taken care of today, it's over. And I usually do that, and I don't know why, you know, somehow I mitigated my own principles. So I just like to share that even mentor coaches make.
Well, sorry to interrupt. Did you have a special offer that went along with it as well? Like you often do? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's like offer's gone.
Yeah. It was gone.
And so if they were to start back up, would you, you know, and they were interested in moving forward, would you remove the sweetened offer? If they're like, hey, I've got $10,000 to what, you know, whatever it is.
That is a great question. It depends.
Okay.
Okay. If I'm just getting started in business and the cable bill is due and I really need money, I'm going to mitigate my principles. Truth be told, when I first got started, you bend, you know, you're, you got to put your ego on the shelf sometimes because you want your, you need the money. Okay. If my business as it is today, I can afford to say no to a few people because it's just not going to be worth the time and trouble for when you have somebody who you know is a pathological liar. Are they going to change their character for you? No. The third alternative, Hava, I would think is to double your price.
Mm-hmm.
Hava, we had a problem last time. And if we're going to do this correctly, my price just went up. My price just went up 50% and I need it today. Can we do business or is this over? Because I'm not going to do what we did last time.
Yeah.
What would you like to do next?
I can't make it happen. It's over.
Okay. Goodbye.
Yeah.
Boom. So you either depends on where your finances are at the time, or can you increase, because you know this person was a problem in the past, can you make more money because for whatever reason they came back to you? Can you increase your price? This is an interesting topic. Anybody else have a pathological liar story or prospect?